learners. I'm Dr. Ritika Sharma, Assistant Professor, Amity Institute of Education, Amity University, Uttar Pradesh. In this session, I'm going to discuss about interest and curiosity of learners. So, what is the process of learning and why it is required that we should give emphasis on learners' interest and learners' curiosity? Before discussing this topic, first, let us try to understand that what all is required from learner's end in the process of learning. The most important thing which is required is willingness of the learner towards learning. It means, if a learner is not having any intrinsic motivation about learning, then retention of the content for the longer time is not possible. The second important point is that learner will show the willingness to learn. It further depends upon the need, interest, and attention of the learner. That's why many times you must have heard that teacher should organize the content according to the need and interest of the learner is emphasized by many people. If teacher is putting efforts for making the learning process need-based and keeping the interest of student in mind, then learning process will be successful with the successful achievement of learning objectives. Further, it is equally important that learning experiences also make important contribution towards the learning acquisition of the learner. For all these requirements of teaching learning process will be successfully fulfilled if we focus on the important aspects of elements of learner's behavior, that is interest of the learner in the learning process. For all requirements of learning to be fulfilled, this is the basic requirement that we should see whether the learner is interested in learning or not. So let us first discuss the meaning and definition of interest. As per the dictionary meaning, a feeling that causes special attention to something is called interest. And Webster defines interest as excitement of feeling accompanying special attention to some object or concern. Interest can also be considered as the pleasant feeling due to which we pay more attention towards particular activity. Students get curious about how, why, and when. These questions should be discussed in the classroom environment in an open way so that students ready to dedicate their time to find answers to it. The more they explore, the more they get exposure for the better understanding of the concept, because curiosity works as a guiding force for them. Now, we will discuss various characteristics of interest. Number one is interest is preconditioned to attention, which means learners pay attention to any activity or any event if pleasant feeling or interest is there for that particular task. It means we pay attention to certain activity if we get some pleasant feeling out of it. You must have experienced that if things are not attracting you, you do not pay attention to it. Next point is, interest can be developed. It is the biggest challenge for the teacher in making the learner interested in their subjects. But yes, interest can be developed. To do this, there is a need to understand the root causes of lack of interest from learner's end. This may be due to difficulty in understanding the subject matter. It may be due to the emotional difficulties, or learning disabilities may be the other reason. Interest works as the motivational force and provides energy and strength to successfully complete the task. It is quite evident that when we show interest in any activity or in any event, we give time. We ready to give time and we also pay more attention to it because we attach our liking to that event. Next, the development of interest. Environmental and psychological factors play important role. It is not possible without the good environment and the better psychological conditions that one person can develop interest. For example, if a teacher wants to develop students' interest in a particular subject, he or she need to see the nature of classroom environment and the reinforcement strategies the teacher is planning to use to strengthen the desired behavior of the student. Next interesting point is, interest may not be fixed and permanent. This is mainly evident in the behavior of students, where their interest may vary from time to time according to the needs and requirement of a particular situation. This may be due to the fact that students during school life get exposure to many new things, and sometimes due to the aversive experience they lost their interest in one or the other activity. Now we will discuss the characteristics of interest with the point of view of the maturation level. It is not fixed that every time we will get a variation in the interest of an individual. With the increase in the maturation level, individual gets stability in finding his interest towards specific activity. Now, another important point is that individual differences also matter in the process of acquisition and finalization of the interest. That means that interest varies from person to person. One person may like one event, whereas the same event may be disliked by the other person. In learning process, understanding of this point is very important for teachers, that students sitting in their class as a whole may have different needs, different interest, which may reflect in their performance in the class. Therefore, it is very important to understand that comparison between the performance of the student should not be taken as the criteria of evaluation of the students. Next point is that interest can be measured. All interests are not only manifested but can be measured through formal or informal way. In a formal way, interest, inventories, scales are used for the measurement of the interest, whereas in the informal way, individual's self-expression about his or her interest shows that what is the liking or disliking of the person. So now you must have understood through this discussion that learning is directly associated with the interest of the individual in that process. Now we will discuss types of interest. There are three main types of interest: expressed interest, manifested interest, and measured interest. In expressed interest, the person expresses his preferences or likings. For example, in teaching learning environment, learner mention about their liking and disliking of the subjects. And same about the expression of interest for games. You must have heard that student mention in teaching learning process in their classrooms with their teachers that they like this subject or they dislike other subject. The expressed interest provide first source of knowing the interest of the learner. But it is not very reliable, as such expression may change with the time and the situation, and also depending upon the maturity of the person. The second type is manifested interest. Manifested interest is that interest which is not only expressed but observed by others while the individual is engaged in the activity.
Let us understand this point with the help of example. That many times we have seen students playing in the playground, that time they are not expressing that they are interested in that particular game. But through their behavior, we came to know that which student is taking interest in which game. This is the example of manifested interest, where somebody else is observing the person who is interested in that particular event or activity. The third type of interest is the measured interest. It is the estimation of individual interest. Like I have already discussed with you, that how we measure the interest with the help of some standardized inventories or scales. And we can measure that how much interest one person is showing in a particular activity and what is the level of interest of that individual. Now, in this context, the role of teachers to develop interest among students in learning process is very, very important topic. So what we need to do as a teacher, what should be the role in the classroom or outside the classroom? So first of all, we should relate our subject matter with daily life of the learner. It will definitely help to develop the interest of the student in the subject. Because you know, when students feel connection of the subject matter with their daily life, they feel that whatever they are learning have some application in their life. The second point is that being a teacher, we need to make content interesting. By saying this, to make the content interesting, I mean that we should make use of maximum senses of the learner. The third point is that we should try to provide first-hand experience to the learners to establish the principles of learning by doing. For example, if possible, we can take students to the field trips or some educational visits where we can give first-hand experience to the learner, and definitely this type of activity will help learner to develop their interest. Another point is that nowadays, with the advancement of technology, we should also use digital tools in our classrooms. There are many educational apps available with the help of technology, which we can use in our classroom. There are open educational resource materials which are very helpful for learners as well as teachers to develop interest in subjects. Being a teacher, we need to see that we have to give less stress on rote memorization. We should always try to relate the application and utility of the content, whatever we are telling to the student. This will help us to minimize the rote memorization among student. Now let us discuss the next interesting concept, curiosity. Curiosity can be defined as an intense desire for knowledge, to explore new things, face the challenges through new experiences. It is a kind of guidance force which helps to explore and try new things to acquire new knowledge. Now, there are different types of curiosity. Daniel Berlin in 1954, he gave the classification of curiosity. He gave the classification as, there are different curiosity: perceptual curiosity, epistemic curiosity, specific curiosity, and diversive curiosity. The perceptive curiosity is that where we perceive the information from the environment just to know about the event. So as the name suggests, it is about the perception. Perception about the event or any activity. So this is the first type of curiosity. In epistemic curiosity, we do not only gather information as we have gathered in perceptive curiosity, but we try to understand it so that it is called as one step ahead from the perceptive curiosity. Now, next type is specific curiosity. Specific curiosity is that where our desire is to explore about specific event or activity. Whereas in diversive curiosity, we deals with the general desire. It means specific curiosity deals with the specific task and diversive curiosity deals with the general task. Now, nature and characteristics of curiosity. Effectiveness of learning depends upon the curiosity level of the learner. The more curious is the learner, there are more chances of effective learning. Because if the student is ready to learn, if the student is ready to explore, if student is ready to construct the knowledge, it means we classify that student as curious to know. So there will be effective learning. Second point is curiosity leads to inventions and innovation. There is no doubt in this point that if the individual is curious to know and to explore new things, definitely that will lead to the new inventions and innovations. So if we provide that environment to our learners where they can satisfy their curiosity, they can get more opportunity to explore. Definitely, they will invent new ideas, they will give innovative ideas which will be helpful for their better understanding. Curiosity also helps in sustaining intrinsic motivation. Intrinsic motivation is something which is there within the individual. It means that when one person is curious about a task or an event, and if that person get the satisfaction, automatically that person will get motivation from within to do more such work in future. Curiosity helps in improving observation skills. If the person is curious, it means that person is having good observation skills, because you have to explore the material, you have to explore the situation. It means there is a requirement of good observation skills. So being curious also helps to improve in observation skills. Now, let us discuss nature and characteristics of curiosity. It reinforces cognitive skills of the learners. Because when we are ready to learn new things, when we are showing interest, we are showing desire, automatically our cognitive skills reinforce. It also helps us in the better understanding of the situation, and accordingly it helps in decision making. Because the person who is curious, that person will definitely explore the possibility of all positive and negative aspect of the any event. So automatically that person will take decision which will be helpful for the understanding. It keeps learner energetic and active for learning new things, because the person who is curious will construct his knowledge. He will not only receive, he will construct the knowledge. And the person who is constructing knowledge, definitely that person will be energetic and active. Now the next point is curiosity compels brain to exercise. Whenever a learner will get the opportunity to explore the different aspects of a task, there will be an exercise in the brain to get the maximum outcome of that activity. That being a teacher, what strategies we can use to promote interest and curiosity among learners? This is the major responsibility of the teacher. So for that, the most important point is the teacher should be self-curious. It is not only the student part that we expect students to be curious. Being a teacher, we should also be self-curious because we put self-examples in front of the student. The second point is, we should engage our learners in question-answer skill. It means we should be open in our classroom that as many questions as students want to ask, we should accept and we should satisfy their queries. We should accept their ideas and also appreciate their ideas in front of the other student so that other student also get motivation to be curious to explore the content matter. We can also give some challenging tasks to the student. It will help them to exercise, it will help them to explore, and it will give a good feedback to the student that yes, they have capacity to complete the task. Very important point nowadays that we should give exposure to the learner with new techniques of learning. New techniques of learning, I have shown some of the pictures in this slide that how some educational games, some virtual trips, engagement in virtual labs and some educational apps can help learner to become more curious. Every time it is not possible for a teacher to take student in the field, every time it is not possible for a teacher to give first-hand experience to the learner. So what a teacher can do? A teacher can do nowadays, there are so many options. If you will explore the technology, you will explore the open educational resources, you will come to know that there are many possibilities, for example, like virtual trips. You can also explore those trips where you cannot physically present, but yes, you can gain the knowledge. The same kind of experience can be given to the student through the virtual labs. So whatever is the experience student getting through these new technology, that will definitely help them to be more curious about the subject matter. We can also do one thing to promote the interest and curiosity among learner, that we can make them active listener, because it is very important if we want to develop interest in any subject, first we should listen. So it also helps in the improvement of our listening skills. The very, very important point to promote interest and curiosity of the learner, that content should be related to the needs and daily life of the learner. Learner should get to know that how that content which is learned in the classroom or in other environment will helpful in the daily life of the learner. We should also encourage our student to practice reflection writing. It will give them chance to more explore about the various aspects which we might be possible not discuss in the classroom. We should also encourage our student to take risk. Risk in the sense that they should take some ideas which may be innovative, but later on that may contribute for their better achievement. We should also suggest students that they should practice meditation for avoiding any psychological issues, because we want to promote interest and curiosity. To promote interest and curiosity, we need healthy mind. For healthy mind, meditation will be very, very helpful. We should also help our student to make them more creative. By saying this, it means that we should always appreciate the original work of the student and we should appreciate their efforts and we should provide the feedback to the student and how they can further improve. So dear learners, through this session, we discuss that what role interest and curiosity plays in the learning process of the learner. Being a teacher, if we put little efforts in our process, we can definitely make our student more interested and more curious in teaching learning process. Thank you so much.